Hi, I'm Cindy with Resin Obsession, and we're here today down in the workshop where I want to show you sanding and drilling into your resin. I've got a few things kind of set up, and it's just ways that work for me. You've got to experiment and find out what works for you, so I'm going to show you a few ways that you might try. There's some real simple ways where you can take some wet dry sandpaper. You can find this mostly the really higher grits, like the 1000, 1200, 2000 and stuff. You can find them at the automotive store. This is what they use when they're sanding down the cars, you know, and repairing and stuff like that. And you know, you can just hand sand, and that's fine. You can sit it in a dish of water, or you know, just spray it and do some hand sanding. Or you can take and cut this and glue it onto an emery board, you know, to a filing stick. Glue it onto there, and that helps control it a little bit better and sand your sides like that. Or take one of these cushioned emery boards. They work really great because you can get in there and get the sides, and these come in different grits too, you know, because really and truly that acrylic nails that they put on, that's nothing more than resin. Okay, so same thing. Okay, so you can use that, file down, get all that nice and smooth. And it really works really fast. But if you're doing high production and stuff like that, you know, you might want to move on to motorized. And what I've got set up here is my Dremel into the clamp. So that way I've got it running, and I've got it, something to hold it like this. And then I've also got a foot pedal down here so I can control the speed. I can start real slow, you know, or I can get a high speed, either one. So that really helps too. So I just kind of started off real slow. And another thing too, I almost forgot. On this piece here, the edges are kind of real soft and jelly-like, and it's the transparent blue dye. But some of the other dyes do this too. I get too much dye in the resin, and so that's what made it soft and jelly like that. And you know, sometimes you do that. Sometimes it's not as thick of a pour as it should be, like this butterfly here, you know. Look at this. You know, but sometimes you may want that, you know. What if I want to glue this on, you know, to a bottle or something, you know, and I've embedded, you know, something in there. Hey, look, you want that. So sometimes goof-ups work out, okay? So keep stuff. Don't ever throw any of this stuff away, okay? Because, you know, you'll figure something out, and if you don't, email me and we'll figure something out together, okay? So anyway, back to this piece here, and you might want to cut away some of the stuff with like a knife, and that can cut back some on the amount that you have to sand. Or you can take a pair of scissors, you know, and cut away some of it, and that'll cut back on what you have to sand, you know. And some of you, you may pour just really good and really exact, and you don't have to cut or sand anything, you know. And to those of you, I say congratulations, you know. But some of us, we have to sand, or we're perfectionists, and we sand and do all that other stuff. So anyway, foot pedal, and I can get it going kind of slow. And while I'm showing you this, I'm not wearing my mask. but normally I would be. I wear a big hunker. I wear this kind of dust mask, okay,
over like this.
Because this is really very fine particles when you start sanding. And that can get all up into your sinuses, to your lungs, and it's going to cause some big problems, okay? So protect yourself. Wear a dust mask. Wear some eye protection, okay? Because you never know when one of these little bands might break off and go flying and hit you in the eye or something like that, okay? So just protect yourself, okay? So anyway, I'm going to go to sanding. You can get it nice and flat on the bottom. You know, sand down your edges. And if you've got a piece that's too small, kind of hard to handle or something, I put a piece of masking tape and make me a little tab. So I've got something to hold on to. And it especially comes in handy, like these little bitty teardrop pieces here, you know, where I'm getting in and I want to sand my very edges where I'm really not sanding hardly any at all. I just want to take that sharpness off the edge there. Well, I really don't have very much to hold on to, so I just put those little tabs on there, okay? So we've got that. Another little trick too, you'll notice that you might start going through a lot of these little sanding bands. They sell these big old rubber block things for cleaning off your belt sanders. And I'm talking about your big wood belt sanders. I'll show you some of my machines because I have a wood furniture background, okay? So they sell these for cleaning those. So you can clean these little things. See? All nice and clean. They'll last a lot longer, okay? Now you can't find these just everywhere. I found mine at Sears. Big old home improvement stores, they usually don't carry them. But, you know, just look around and you'll find one. And so, for sanding, I think that's probably about it. Okay, if you have any questions or if there's something I forgot, email me, okay? Next, I'm going to move on to drilling, but I probably have to do that in a separate video. They probably run over to my 10 minutes, okay? Okay. Bye.